down. Paid the cost to be the boss. Paid the cost to be the boss.
That's the main why. And I think that's almost enough, right? How? How's a different story? Okay. So, obviously, you're going to have to take baby steps, right? If your crew doesn't know how to do any of these things that, you're responsible for, that you have to get done, right? Your task, your 10, 12, 15, 20 tasks you got to get done, you know, every single day. If they don't know how to do it, then you're going to have to train them, okay? You're going to have to teach them how to do all these things. Now, baby steps again. You can't expect them all to just figure it out, right? You're going to have to start with your assistant managers, your go-to people, right? The people who are getting paid the most. Give them a big chunk of the pie, right? You're taking a big chunk. They got to take a big chunk too.
In other words, it's a huge shit sandwich and we're all going to have to take a bite.
Now, it's not going to be as big maybe as yours, but they're going to have more, maybe the more serious tasks to get done. So, you're going to take one of these guys and you're going to spend some time with them and you're going to teach them. You're going to teach him how to get this thing done, how to do it, how to figure it out on his own so that he can do it from now on all by himself with minimal supervision. And then you'll just jump in to back him up, you know, whenever he gets stuck while you're doing your own stuff. Okay. The next day you teach someone else another task, and the next day another person, and the next day another person, and the next day another person. And that's how you do it, little by little, little by little. That's it. That's all it takes, guys. Once your crew is trained on how, damn, it looks really pretty out here. Once your crew is trained on how to do more assignments, more tasks, one, they feel more important, you know, they have a sense of pride, you know, because they feel like, oh, well, my boss, you know, trusts me for, you know, this manager thing, you know, that only managers do, and I do it for him, you know, because he believes in me, or he trusts me, or he has faith in me, or whatever. They'll feel nice and warm and fuzzy, right? Meanwhile, you're making your job easier, and they're learning more tasks. Okay. Now, once your people have learned more things, then you can start to cross train them, right? Even further. So your guy that normally, you know, files your paperwork, you know, has never scanned in inventory, you know, and someone else has you already gave that assignment to somebody else. Okay, so now the other person, you swap them, have that person, you know, file the paperwork, and the other guy, you know, do the inventory. Because guess what? People call in sick, people quit, people get fired. You know, there's going to be days where you're not going to have that main go-to person, right? So make them all your main go-to person. Teach them all how to do everything. In case somebody's missing, somebody calls in, somebody leaves for another job, somebody whatever. In case you're missing somebody, somebody else can step right in their shoes and take over without a hiccup, without skipping a beat, okay? Once your guys are more trained, what I used to do to spread out the load is every morning when I would open, I would get a sheet of paper and I would write down everyone's name in order of which they began their shift, right? So I'd have like my morning crew written on top of the list, and as the list went down, it was, you know, people who were coming in later and later into the day. Now for every person, everybody, I would have their name on the paper, and next to their name, I would have what assignment I needed them to do, right? In some cases, I'd even put a time frame of what time I wanted it done by, and or what time I wanted them to start, because I have everything planned out in the schedule, right? So I'm like, okay, this guy starts at 10, but from 10 to 12, you know, there's not much coverage. So at 12, I get my other person coming in, and at that point, now I can have my 10 o'clocker take care of this assignment. So I'd have time frames like that next to their name. And I would write there, you know, various things. you know, depending on the person and depending on the day and whatnot, I would write down next to their name, you know, so-and-so files, you know, these three reports. So-and-so checks all of the returns. So-and-so, you know, does my inventory. So-and-so is going to do cycle count. So-and-so's, I'd have everything on there. I'd have everything down to, like, you know, who's throwing out the trash, who's cleaning the break room, who's, you know, pulling certain merchandise from the back room up to the front, you know, and I'd split it up. One, I'd do it for myself, you know, so that I could breathe and spread out the load. Another reason that I'd also document it on paper is so I can hold them accountable, right? Because they'd have to initial it. Another reason is because they would see what everyone else is doing too. Now they don't feel like they're being singled out, like, oh, well, why do I have to do this? Well, look at what so-and-so is doing. That guy's got it even worse than you. Oh, shoot. Yeah. So this guy's doing this. This guy's doing that. Everyone's doing something. I'm doing this too. Like, no one's not doing anything. Everyone's got something to do, you know? Even the person, even down to the part-timer who only worked maybe a few hours, you know, like, that person had maybe a small task. That person had to clean the bathroom before they left, you know? Something. Everything that had to get done in the day was documented on that paper with their names, who had to do what, and they'd have to initial it. And the day would go by smooth.
We're all gonna have to take a bite.
Now, would everything get done every single day? No. No, not everything would get done every single day. If there was maybe 20 assignments on there and 15 got done, hey, it's not bad. Because you know what? If you try to do everything by yourself, maybe you'd get 8 done. And you'd be stressed the fuck out because you weren't able to do the other 12. Now you're getting past due and backed up and everything starts to snowball, right? So use your crew. Now, once everyone is doing all these things, I mean, you can get to the point where you're not doing any of them. I mean, who's the best one on the counter? You, right? It's probably why you got promoted. Purely because your sales were awesome and your customer service was awesome. It's probably why you got promoted. Well, if you have everyone else doing your job, so to speak, now you're free. Now you can spend time doing the easiest thing for you, what got you to your position, which is selling. And you can spend time with your crew up front on the counter, working side by side with them, you know, and shadowing them. And listening to how they talk to the customers, you know, you can probably rescue sales because they may not be doing something that you would do, or pitching it the way you would pitch it, right? Or you can add on to the sale where you see opportunity, where your people may not, right? What I used to tell my people, especially when I was shorthanded, is don't help anyone at the counter. You guys do what I assigned you guys to do. Leave me alone on the counter. I will help every single customer. Don't come and help me unless I ask for your help, because I can handle a lot, right? And if a customer approaches you down one of the aisles, then just bring them to me, you know, take down all their information on a piece of paper, give it to me, and then let them know that as soon as I'm available, I'll be helping them out, you know, and I'll acknowledge them and I'll help them out as soon as I'm done with the customer in front of them. But you go back to doing what you got to do. This is how I kept the store clean. This is how I kept up to date on tasks. This is how I got promoted. It got to the point where I was a, for you sports fanatics, I was quarterbacking from the counter. So I was at the counter. I'd watch everyone coming in and out. I'd help every customer that came in and out. Meanwhile, I'm observing all of my crew members up on the sales floor, taking care of all the tasks that had to get done that normally I would have to do. So I keep my tabs on everybody. I help all the customers. I'm observant of everything. I'm well aware. I'm in the mix, so to speak. So it's for me, it's what worked, and it seemed to be, you know, fantastic. So use this tip. Train your people. Assign jobs to everybody. Put it on paper so that everybody can see who's doing what. And do it every single day. Be consistent. Every single day, do it. Every single day, do it. No matter if you're shorthanded. If you're shorthanded or if you're overstaffed, you still got to get everything done. No one's going to care that you're shorthanded. There's never going to be an excuse. Hey, boss, sorry. You know, I didn't get all this stuff done because I'm shorthanded. What's your boss going to say? Hey, man, you've been shorthanded for 3 months. When are you going to hire somebody? Who's running the store? When you're shorthanded also, you don't run the store. the store ends up running you. And it's going to run you into the ground if you don't get it under control. That's going to be it for right now, guys. I made this video way too long. If you have any questions or any other comments, if you want to, you know, chime in and let me know how you've done it, you know, what's helped you as a manager to become successful, to be on top of all your things, to not stress the fuck out, then let me know. I think it would be beneficial for everybody on here to see what everyone has done in the past or in the present, you know, so that they maybe can do it in the future. Until next time, everybody, it's your boy Steve from Off the Clock. Tips and tricks. Make sure to like and subscribe. Give me that thumbs up so that I know that you appreciated this video. And until next time, everybody, peace.
In other words, it's a huge shit sandwich and we're all gonna have to take a bite.
Get down! Paid the cost to be the boss.